Hey fellow agents, this is Agent Smith, and we are streaming Zelda Breath of the Wild on the Switch. And just to go over this again, I have a license to use Nintendo's content in this video through the Nintendo's Creators Program. This video is not sponsored or endorsed by Nintendo, but any advertising revenue from this video will be shared with Nintendo. Now that we got that out of the way, let's go ahead and continue on. So in the previous episode, I had gone through and cleared all four of the shrines that are located here. And last I spoke to the old man, he stated to go to a point where these all cross in a form of an X. And it honestly looks like it's about here, but I'm guessing because this is the nearest place to us, I would say it's probably actually the Temple of Time. Oh, actually, that's not even a place. That's my place I started. So, from here to here. Oh, yeah, the Temple of Time is definitely the location. So, I'm going to work my way around through here and come down through the Forest of Spirits and come up to the Temple of Time that way. So, hey, you got a whole bunch of markers. That's cool. Delete that stamp. So that's pretty cool. Anyway, we'll go ahead and start exploring. And as always, feel free to chat. I have a text to voice feature put on, so I can hear when you guys speak to me, and I'm always happy to reply to any conversations you guys want to have. Well, let's see if I can get down here. Keep dropping down as much as I can without hurting myself. There we go. Ooh, that's not good. And unstable. Don't touch him. Back off. There we go. Gotcha. A white choo-choo jelly. A jiggly substance that came from an ice choo-choo. It's cold to the touch. Cool to the touch. And squeezing it seems to relieve stress. If struck, it will explode in a cold mist. There's all these path stones that look like they're heading down. I was wondering if there's something over this way to take a look at. Oh, I gotta be careful while I'm standing next to these guys. Excuse me. Lots of choo-choo jellies. Let's see. I got a few heart ones. I don't really need it for the cold, but I'll take it anyway. Oh, we don't need that big an arrow. Hoping I can catch that second one too. I'm all about this hunting. There we go. My cold resistance high enough, it doesn't seem to affect me anymore. Ran out of that weapon. Let's go with the Traveler's Spear. And there it is. In a cave behind a waterfall with three chests. and a sword. Check these chests real quick. 5 arrows. And 5 more. 5 fire arrows. Blah, 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 blah. And a spiked boko bow. That one would be good. What do we have here? Soldier's broadsword. I'll take that right now. And this looks like the strongest we have. Bows. There we go. Yeah. I got a clumsy cat roaming around if you hear anything banging. Quicker. Gotta get our way across. Like I said, I want to go along the outside edge of this whole entire place and see if I can find anything. I have to go and search that side of the lake at some point here. For all the YouTube fans out there, if you're interested, I've got Alien Isolation videos up, and I should be getting more and continuing in the series sometime this evening. I'll probably get around to recording and getting everything set up for tomorrow and the next few days. I got quite a bit I've got to try to fill in time-wise. Cool if I could lift myself. We need magnesis. Not the place to test out whether I can do it though. Good enough. Ancient screws for days. Oh, here's a whole crew of enemies. Shoot, he alerted everybody before I got a chance. At least the archer's down. Come on, buddies. Aren't you gonna come down? I'll come up and get you. Oh, coming after me after all. Ooh, this is a strong sword. Oh, you son of a bitch. He got me on that one. Holy shit. I don't throw my sensitive self to enemies with a mail. There, dead before alerted. Oh, hell yeah. Oh, that was a perfect timing, too. I've not been able to get a perfect dodge since I've been doing this. It's an even sword, much similar to the one I already have. Do you know what? I have guts. A rare material obtained by defeating a Bokoblin. It convulses on its own every now and then, which is really creepy, but perhaps it has a use. I wonder what it's for. I think I'm going to go ahead and clear. I don't need. This spear is weak. So I could drop that one. I can figure. There we go. Pick up another broadsword, because you never know when you're going to need an extra one. I think I also have a crap shield, too, that I could probably get rid of. Like this pot lid could probably be dropped. And take this Boko shield, just in case. Come on down, guys. Right into the ground, as hard as it could be. It slapped them both with a sword. Five more arrows. And some amber. What does that go down to? There's like nothing. It's like the edge of the world over here. If I can make it to the top of this thing. Oh yeah, it looks like I'll make it. I'm almost already there and I've got half my energy left. There we go. Five more arrows. Looks like there's a village up on top of this hill. I'm gonna go check that out. Didn't see me coming. Rest. If I aim high, aim real high. Well, I got his attention. Bring it on. They're all awake and dancing now. You guys can't resist this. Horns and fangs, more horns. really wish I knew what these are for. Oh, I could have pushed them right off the edge with that. That'd have been entertaining. You live and learn, right? More amber. Some arrows from the archer one. There's a clear drop. There's something down there. There's something over here. I think that's something. Like a square in the rocks. Or is that just a shadow? Nope, it's just bushes. This is something here. Let's climb down, y'all. Oh, I'm so dead. Yeah, it's not a useful battle tip. What else you got? Instead of throwing yourselves at enemies, nope. Depending on the height. Alright, let's try that again. This time with a whole lot less stupid. Anyway, as I was saying, I should be able to climb down this rock face. Going down should at least get me close enough to where I can drop off safely, right? I definitely need to have more stamina. Yeah, I'm almost there. You can climb a pretty decent distance without even worrying. Well, down is probably less energy burning, though, now that I think about it. Oh. Magnesis. Oof. There's another Korok. You found me. Thanks, bud. Bye-bye. Did it again. So get used to these controls. All right, down jumps off of rocks. Yeah, yeah. I was trying to jump diagonally. But apparently, down, no matter what the angle, counts as trying to jump backwards. Oh, here we go. Whole series of enemies here. I fire on this one right here. Headshot. Didn't even know it hit him. Oh, you sleepy sleepers won't know what's gonna happen. Apples. Huck. Always take an apple when you can find them, right? Let's see. Work my way down. Fairly safely. Little Bokoblins can't take me. The Windu here is strong. Well, there wasn't anything special, huh? Just normal chest. Fire arrows. Bow, some regular. Oh man, I could have fired at that. That would have been even better. Boy, it would have probably set fire to this whole area. Wonder if I could. See if I could fire a fire arrow at it. There we go. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Back away. Yeah, it's burning off all of the grass through here. Blowing it straight back. If it would have set fire to the land, it would have just passed right on through. That's pretty cool. Light a tree branch from cutting a tree branch. Okay. Into the forest. I don't think I have any real food. Not particularly ones that create stamina. Sorry about that bang there.
It looks like I'll miss it again.
No! Dang it. Alright. We have to find a way to cook some food up. Archer shot. There's some meat. Got that one. Spiked Bokobo is already destroyed. What the heck? Man, that was quick. Strong strength, low survival time. shit. They got sneak striking? They don't even know I'm here. Whoop, whoop. Personal achievement, cleared a base of Bokoblins without being noticed. And some opal. Shiny blue flower or something over here. Blue nightshade, a plant that grows in quieter areas of Hyrule. At night, gives off a soft glow. Cook it with to increase its stealth. Your stealth. Recognize this. Let's go ahead and save this just in case. What is that? A Chickaloo tree nut. Small birds love this nut. You can eat it raw for minor effect, but it can also be added as a spice to other recipes. That's a new one for me. That looks like a lizard. Or a bird. Or maybe it's the squirrel I've been trying to get. Nope, just another high-tail lizard. Oh yeah. Oh, fuck me. Alright. Crap, alright. Ooh, that was close. That'll work. Blow your face off. Oh shoot, I don't have any weapons. Alright, we need to eat something. Thank you. Sorry about that, guys. I got a phone call. I had to go answer. I'll take this and... Oh, excuse me. Get the hiccups now. And a mushroom. That'll fill me up. Hopefully. There we go. Oh, I don't have a weapon. Shoot. Oh, that's just not a good... There we go. Alright. Alright, alright. Now we got you. Ooh, right in the wall. Keep wanting to do Z target combined. Come on, let me get this. I miss. Do it like this. There we go. Come on, get off of me. Gosh dang it. Alright, I gotta figure out how to get onto this guy. And remember where my jump button is. I'm just gonna climb right on top of you now. There you go. Oh, oh, oh. Ooh, get out of the way, get out of the way. Bam. Drop all them bomb arrows. Don't have any more. Alright, I'm gonna have to be a little bit more careful now. Damn it. Get up, get up, get up. I wanted to be able to climb him, but I gotta be able to get around the shot. There we go. Fall down. Yeah. You got nothing, buddy. There it is. Rubies, amber, opal, flints. Sweet. Let's pick up whatever I can find in here. That explosive method's kind of worked. Kind of worked. What else we got going on? Yeah, the music is very, like, backgroundy on a real crazy song going on or anything crazy like that. It was just a little bit of music to accompany the combat. Oh, hey. Y'all back off. I want that honey. More nightshade. Oh, here we go, some more Bokoblin. Oh, fuck it, all right. Is he attracted to that? Gotcha. Got double raw meat. He was actually worth something. Put all my arrows back, pick up some Bokoblin horn, and get this treasure chest. I'd seen a tree like this before. It was cut off. Makes me wonder if I were to put a bomb into the center of this. What would happen? Nothing much. Just an explosion inside a tree. Wow, this is big. Let's see if I can climb this. It's like the old Deku tree. No, nothing up here. Just can see things from a high view. Look over this whole forest of the year. I'm going the opposite direction I should be. Lead it. Oh, nope. Back of him up. He's gone. Be gone. Gonna try to lead him. Yes. That's some more. Aw, oh, didn't kill him. I was all assured myself that I was gonna get some more boar meat off of him. Huh? That was random. Weird pillar of rocks. Figure I'd go up there. How many of these are up here? Oop. Did I just successfully hit something? Hit a damn bird. Huh. That's a lucky roll. I remember seeing a cave entrance below the cave I came out of. Oh, that should put it along here somewhere. I'm gonna get a squirrel sooner or later. There it is. Amber. Right in the snout. Gotcha, frog. Slap across your face. I mean, Boko slap. You guys just like standing out here in this field? At a random. Alright, we'll head straight up this way. Precarious rock. I missed both of them. Oh, there's a quick choo-choo jelly, a gelatinous substance that came from a regular choo-choo. It's unstable in this state, but applying a bit of elemental stimulation can change its form. I'm looking for some of these. A healthy herb grows abundantly in the plains of Hyrule. Cook it before eating it to increase the number of hearts it restores. Just jump instead of climbing. The timing's not right. We gotta get this. I gotta learn this timing. Or I can just fucking kill him. Oh, that was a bug. Dang it, dang it, dang it. Like, I gotta just run around spamming the A button. Let us see. There we go, it's an apple. And a roasted bird drumstick. I'll go ahead and eat that right now. And I'll have the test mushrooms I have. That wasn't enough to take him out in one. There you go. More choo-choo jelly. Hmm. Decent pants. About damn time, because these capris was not working. There we go. That's proper. I should have come down here a long time ago. Alright, let's get to the top of this thing. Because the pinpoint X pointed us out to here. We are lit. It looks like it's about to storm. But this is cloudy day. Now let's pray. You who have conquered the shrines and claimed their spirit orbs, I could offer you great power. It appears you have claimed 4 spirit orbs. In exchange for 4 spirit orbs, I will amplify your being. So tell me, what is it that you desire? I want more stamina. Because that's the one thing that has been hindering me the most. I want to be able to climb, move, and run whenever I want, as fast as I want. I'll expand your stamina wheel, yes. To grant the power you seek. Sure, everybody goes freaking hearts right off the bat, but stamina is more important to me. The size of your stamina wheel has been increased, allowing you to perform more actions before getting tired. Oh yeah, okay, I see. Go and bring peace to Hyrule. The blessing of the goddess has made you that much more resilient, I see. Here I am. Get up here, quickly. Well, it shouldn't be a problem. I should be able to climb straight up the face of this thing. Cause stamina like a mug. Well, it's a little more stamina. But I can still climb straight up the face of this better than I would have been able to before. I'd have been there way down below. Oh, it's so broken. All right. Let's get an ancient screw and come back up this side. If this works. If I work my way around, I might be able to find myself a ledge or two to climb onto and rest. Or just straight climb it. There we go. That's better. Now, where did he go? That's cool. I can run so much longer. Well, sort of longer. There he is.
Well done there, young one. Now then, the time has come to show you who I truly am. I was King Rhoam Bosphoramus Hyrule.
I knew it.
I was the last leader of Hyrule. A kingdom which no longer exists. The Great Calamity was merciless. It devastated everything in its path, Lo, a century ago. It was then that my life was taken away from me. And since that time, here I have remained in spirit form. I did not think it wise to overwhelm you while your memory was still fragile. So rather than that, I thought it best to assume a temporary form. Forgive me. I think you are now ready. Ready to hear what happened 100 years ago. To know Calamity Ganon's true form, one must know the story from an age long past. The Demon King was born into this kingdom, but his transformation into malice created the horror scene. Stories of Ganon were passed from generation to generation in the form of legends and fairy tales. But there was also a prophecy. The signs of a resurrection of Calamity Ganon are clear, and the power to oppose it lies dormant beneath the ground. We decided to heed the prophecy and began excavating large areas of land. It wasn't long before we discovered several ancient relics made by the hands of our distant ancestors. These relics, the divine beasts, were giant machines piloted by warriors. We also found the Guardians, an army of mechanical soldiers who fought autonomously. This coincided with ancient legends oft repeated throughout our land. We also learned of a princess with a sacred power, and her appointed knight chosen by the sword that seals the darkness. It was they who sealed Ganon away using the power of these ancient relics. 100 years ago, there was a princess set to inherit a sacred power and a skilled knight at her side. It was clear that we must follow our ancestors. We selected four skilled individuals from across Hyrule and tasked them with the duty of piloting the divine beasts. With the princess as their commander, we dubbed these pilots champions, a name that would solidify their unique bond. The princess, her appointed knight, and the rest of the champions were on the brink of sealing away Ganon. But nay. Ganon was cunning, and he responded with a plan beyond our imagining. From deep below Hyrule Castle, seized control of the Guardians and the Divine Beasts, and turned them against us. The champions lost their lives, those residing in the castle as well. The appointed knight, gravely wounded, collapsed while defending the princess. And thus, the Kingdom of Hyrule was devastated absolutely by Calamity Ganon. However, The princess survived to face Ganon alone.
Link, you are our final hope. The fate of Hyrule rests with you.
That princess was my own daughter, my dear Zelda. And the courageous knight who protected her right up to the very end. That knight was none other than you, Link. You fought valiantly when your fate took an unfortunate turn. And then, you were taken to the Shrine of Resurrection. Here you now stand, revitalized 100 years later. The words of guidance you have been hearing since your awakening are from Princess Zelda herself.
I knew it again.
And now, as she works to restrain Ganon from within Hyrule Castle, she calls out for your help. However, my daughter's power will soon be exhausted. Once that happens, Ganon will freely regenerate himself, and nothing will stop him from consuming our land. Considering that I could not save my own kingdom, I have no right to ask this of you, Link. But I am powerless here. You must save her, my daughter, and do whatever it takes to annihilate Ganon. Somehow, Ganon has maintained control over all four divine beasts, as well as those guardians swarming around Hyrule Castle. I believe it would be quite reckless for you to head directly to the castle at this point. I suggest that you make your way east out to one of the villages in the wilderness. Follow the road out to Kakariko Village. There you will find the elder Impa. She will tell you more about the path that lies ahead. Consult the map on your Sheikah slate for the precise location of Kakariko Village. Make your way past the twin summits of the Dueling Peaks. From there, follow the road as it proceeds north.
Sounds good. Go on. Here's the paraglider, just as I promised. A paraglider, an item that you can receive from the king on a great plateau. It allows you to sail through the sky. Press X when you're in the air to use it. Complete. With that, you should be able to safely fly off the cliffs surrounding the area. And I think that's it. I've told you everything I can. Link, you must save Hyrule. Oh, that's no small feat. That's better searching for her I can do. The soldier's bow. See how long before I destroy this. Alright. Oh, I can't think of... Oh, yeah. I can think of... I remember what I wanted to do. I wanted to go into that. Yeah. I got the cold weather gear that says I could survive. Plus, there was a bomb hole up down there. A couple of places to look at. There we go. The Put that there. See what's in ya. More amber. Do we get anything other than amber? Lots of wood. Korok leaf. A seared stick. Oh, not pay attention. Oh, it's his arm floating. I was like, what is that in the water? Alright guys, I keep getting distracted over here. A bit drowsy for some reason. What the fuck was I thinking? That was a bad idea. Oh man, I'm lucky to be alive. I just wanted to see if there was a, there we go, that's better. I just wanted to see if there was a, anything of interest or something weird to see along here before I take off. Doesn't look like there's anything along there, but maybe up here. Here we go, some boar. Oops, shit, I hope I didn't alert it. There we go. Raw meat, acorn. My arrow that I first fired. Just a little bit of snow up here. Well, sorry to waste everyone's time. We shall fly off into the sunset. By which I mean directly into this lake so I can go to that bomb wall. Treasure! More opal. Mm-hmm. That's raw. This one'll work. Need this last baked apple. That should be the goods that I need. Place I want to go is that direction. So we will get our way over there as quickly as we can. Jump off this ledge to see what's up. At least I can come back if I missed any of those little Koroks around here. Which I feel like I did. A Keese eyeball. A rare material dropped by a defeated Keese, but it's fun to look at, but it doesn't seem to have much use at first glance. It must be good for something. And some Keese wings. You ready, guys? Gonna take this road all the way there. Or to wherever it is we're headed. I believe we'll be going to Kakariko Village. I wonder if I could see it if I put it in my scope for it. See what places I could see. Be nice to have a zoom feature on this thing too. Well, controls work better. Well, it just keeps on going. Whatever that is, I'm gonna go ahead and tag though. Yes, for sure. I don't see any other towers around here in the area I'm in. I guess that'll be our bit of our target. That puts it right in the smack middle. We gotta head up to Impa's place this way. Sounds good to me. Let's do it. Stop trying to throw your sword, Smith. We. Oh, my weapon's destroyed. Big axe. I mean, big hammer. Ooh, he knocked me right over that wall. Jesus, that guy's big. No. I'm gonna die of the first battle I have out here. Yep. Get up. Eat some meat. There you go. Choo-choo jellies caught me off guard. That is a Boko bat, a clunky club made of by a Bokoblin. If you swing it at an enemy's shield, it may be able to knock the shield out of the foe's hand. It's good to know. What is this? A Moblin. Oh, these are Moblins. Moblin's horn. Splendid horn once grew atop the head of a Moblin. It can't be used in normal food recipes, but it does have some use as an ingredient in making elixirs. Moblin fangs. Sharp fangs obtained from a Moblin. It's too hard to be reshaped into a tool, but it can be tossed into a stoop with some critters to create elixirs. Man. Wonder why I did that. Alright, well, let's keep on going. More of these guardians. A rusted shield. I can't hold any more shields, so. A lot of rusted out weapons here. A treasure. Can't get to it. See if I can magnesis it out. There we go. Open that up. Got me some amber. At least it's daylight. With these videos, I'm officially to a point where I've never seen before. All of this is just new to me. I don't even know what to do. When people say, an open world game, so you can go and do anything you want. And I'm like, that sounds like it's more hassle than it could be worth. Man, oh man, I need to be a hell of a lot more careful about my life. Maybe I should have took the other heart container. 20 rupees, a red luster. It's red luster tickles your heartstring. Do use rupees, alright. I was curious to see if there was money in this. Birds. Delicious birds. Damn, I missed. I could just find a fire to work with. That's a fox. Fox makes delicious meat. There's something. Ooh. All kinds of mushroom.
Let's
Ooh-wee. Oh, there's still more? Got you right before you hit me. Alright. I'll probably eat something before I do something stupid here. I think just dig into the chest, into the dirt. Yeah, because there's more moblins down there. Fortunately, I have plenty of these, but I just don't have a place to cook. I have plenty of meals. Guess I could take the simmer fruit. I'm gonna have to cook a whole lot more small stuff. I'm gonna try to climb this thing and see if I can find some more stuff up here. It also gives me a better view of the land. I should have the strength now to climb straight up these things with minimal effort. Plenty of energy to spare. Sapphires, precious blue gem, mined from natural rock formations. Sapphires contain the very essence of ice. They've been known to fetch a high price since ancient times. Still don't see a town. Do see. I do see that. And the tower I intended. Is that on my map area too? Another one there. I want to see what's on top of that hill. I'm sorry if you guys are expecting me to go straight on to like stories and dungeons and stuff. I mean, no one's actually interacting with my conversation on me on these videos, so I'm kind of exploring as I go. If you guys have a need or desire to see something else done, all you gotta do is hop on while I'm playing and say something. I am more than willing and definitely interested in taking directions, hints or information that you guys might have. There's a rock. With a Korok. I knew there was a reason that was up there. This is why I explore. This is why I'm hot. I wonder how many there were on the main island, though. I mean, the first part that I started at. That's my curiosity. Alright, now that I've gone up here, my map shows that the targets I placed are within the territory I'm in. And also get to this one, so I'm gonna go ahead and try to get to that. We will do it by floating across. That's a swamp. This is a tree. And those are food. Damn. Every time they have to get away before I can draw that extra bow. Did I shoot it all the way down? I bet I did. Hello? Hello? Just hidden in here, huh? You weren't even trying hard. What is that? Is this a town? Was a town? That did nothing. Suppose I need slicing tools to actually cut through that. What's in the water? Sneaky river snails. This large, glow-in-the-dark snail lives in the fresh water. When cooked into a dish, it heightens your senses so you can move about silently. Is there nothing here? There used to be a town here. Was there more in this well than before? What if? Oh, well. That wasn't what I thought was going to happen there. Yep, bye-bye. I just saw the chain and thought maybe I could do something with it, but that works too. A wooden bow. Plain and simple. Oh, son of a bitch. Another one of these things? Alright. Let me get back up on it. Ooh-wee. That thing almost double hit me. Guess I'll take this. Oh, its head's on the bottom now? Well, shit. A Staminoca bass. This Hyrule bass has got the biggest... Got to be the biggest fish by never getting caught until now. Its long life results in cooked... in a cooked dish that will result in a lot of stamina. Okay, this is gonna be different then. Putting it on its butt makes a whole different battle for me. Get away, get away. Oof. One smack and it's over. Alright. I expected there to be a bunch more stone talus in the area, but apparently I was wrong. Fighting those things must be worth just for lots of ore. There's bunches of them around. At least I got the one. And it's daylight now. If this is where the stone talus is, I should be able to choose a weapon. I guess I'll use this. And go ahead and use what bomb arrows. I don't have any bomb arrows left, so no arrows. All right. Is this him? Or is this him? Get off of it. Get off of it. There we go. Boom, you missed. Ow. Oh, shit. Okay. Oh, no, no, no. Okay, so it's gonna be a little bit different. Might take a little while, guys. Hoping to get him to fall down again like he was. I just climb and stand on his back right here. There we go. Alright, now I gotta do is, is find another weapon. Shit. Okay. Well, at least I know I can stand on him. I'm not gonna focus on this right now. I'll come back through this area another time. I wanna get forward moving. I think that I need better weapons anyway before I continue on, and definitely more armor and health. My little 1.25 stamina is not going to help me on combating this guy. So, continuing the path that I was intending. Check these homes, what's left of them anyway. Makes this world like Fallout Hyrule Edition. Am I there yet? Nightshade. There's something else down there. Flower I don't recognize. Some mellow mushrooms. Oh shit. Oh, it's another secret. I recognize this flower, and I'm not supposed to recognize it because it's not. It's one of these little dudes. He's guiding me somewhere. Found you. It's 11. Know what the use or purpose is. It's a sheep. Ride one of those, I suppose. There's my tower. Still don't see evidence of Kakariko, unless that was Kakariko Village. Seriously, hope not. Let's see if I can mount this goat. Damn. Guess I'm not mounting the goat. All right. Apples and acorns. Place there. Oop. Let's climb up here. Ooh-wee. 100 rupees, nice. That should be all I need to get across. Bypass a whole lot of these woods this way. No. Oh, I'm so stupid. Woo! That was close. I'll take it. Not a long distance, but... These buttons are so close together, so... for me, I have very large, wide thumbs from years of playing video games. And, yeah, it feels weird. Trying to play in this little tiny thing. It's so weird not having like a regular weapon. First it wasn't that strange, but now it's starting to become weird. Kill this goat. I stunned him, that's for sure. Just raw meat, huh? Nighttime. No more room. Proxim Bridge, the Dueling Peak Stable. Is that what that is? A stable, huh? It must be quite some ways away because I'm pretty sure that's a Bokoblin camp. Doesn't look like anyone's here, though. What is that? Iron shroom. The cap of the iron of this mushroom is very hard. Use it when cooking to prepare a dish that increases your defense. A torch. Some chests. Axe. Ooh-wee. There we go. Bet you can't break the chest like that. Flint. There's a cooking thing. Finally. Take this woodcutter's axe while I'm at it. Oh, yeah. I happen to have a torch. Oh, I should probably not do that. There we go. I don't know where these guys are at, but we got some cooking to do, y'all. Organize this stuff up. Let's see. Well, we might as well try this thing out. Put it together with some other mushrooms. Tough mushroom skewer. Two hearts and stamina. Old, mix with this, add some nuts. Throw some steak and honey in there. An energizing glazed meat worth up to 13 hearts and some stamina. We'll hold some of these and throw it with some honey. Ooh-wee, 5 in the stamina. Alright. Hold meat and meat. Yeah. Trying to make smaller ones because I don't have a lot of health and I don't want to waste on really big things. A straight meat skewer, not bad. Alright, so what if I just hold and then do these? So straight up meat skewer, 2, okay. Oh. Old. Putting 2 steaks on here. That's just a regular meat skewer as well. One steak and egg. It's still a meat skewer. They don't know what to do with it. Hold nuts. Put a whole bunch of nuts. Sauteed nuts. 2.5. That's better. That's actually something I would use. Put it together like this. With whatever that other new nut type thing is. Smaller sauteed nuts, alright. What if I took all 3 these types of shrooms? Adding a little extra on those ends. Plain old mushroom skewer. Okay. And cook all these apples. One, 2, 3, 5. Nuts and fruit. Make granola. Oh, just a weaker simmering fruit. All right. I thought the acorns were supposed to give flavor. Guess that wasn't literal. Let's see. I'll throw these together. I keep wanting to press X, which makes me jump over and over again. Spicy simmered fruit. What if I just put 5 spices together straight up? Sauteed peppers. 12 minutes in there too. Straight up. That should be good. Mushrooms with herbs. Steamed mushrooms. Just cook 2 eggs by themselves. An omelet. Let's put all this nightshade together and cook it. Sneaky fried wild greens. Very healthy. No hearts, but it's definitely gonna make you sneaky for 10 minutes. Glazed meat. Yeah. What else? Can just cook 2 at a time as we go. Do them 3 at a time. I think it's 3 hearts per. There we go. There we go. Yeah, I should be good. Should be able to survive for a little bit longer than I usually do. What is that? Oh, sweet lord. Almost went through a school of fish. And that river flows. Alright. Climb to the top of this tower. See what we can see. Dueling Peaks Tower. And rest. This tower's built the way it is, man. I tell you, you could just go forever in this world. There's almost too much to see. The completionist in me is like, too much to do, rather quit. Oh, son of a bitch. Well, that was pointless. Okay, if I do that, it's only three, and then rest. And rest. Last run. Climb up quicker. Alright, let's see what happens when I do this one. Give me a map of the land. The Shee Tower is activated. That's cool. Scanning area. There it is. It's all of this area. Regional map extracted. Sheikah Slate update. Additional functionalities detected. What? Sheikah sensor. Oh, searching for shrines. The sensor reacts when you are close to shrines that you have not yet visited. If you head in the direction where the reaction is strongest, you should be able to find the shrine. Sweet. You can disable and disable it all with Y. Well, that's cool. The sensor indicator has been placed near the mini-map. Search for shrines by moving the direction with the strongest signal. Oh, it's saying this way, which I already know, because that was where I was going anyway. That's nowhere near close. That was shitty. I'm about to dive in. Damn fool. Yeah, alert him, that's fine. Still gonna slay your face. Oh, they are stronger now. Holy shit, alright. Turn around a compad. Never mind. I guess. I'll take that so I can defend myself. Nope, that don't work. Alright, Bokoblin's a little bit tougher than I thought. You're gonna have to be a little bit sneakier. Can't just jump in right away and start killing everything that moves. I also need to stop hitting the attack button combined together when I'm jumping. There we go. Yeah, I know there's a shrine nearby. That I can do. This is not a weapon, though. Beat you with your own arms. There we go. There's a little base inside the river. Yeah, it's all the way out that way. So what was it I saw before? Impa Scout, was there just a town that used to be in the middle of the river? Or is that on another part of the map? I bet it's on another part of the map. That's why I couldn't really get into it too much. On a Korok there. I found, yeah, it's on the other part. That's why. Alright. Supposed to be passing through the Dueling Peaks to go speak at Lantern Lake. Speak to Impa, or at least seek her out. But that ain't happening. I'm going for this shrine. Sweet Jesus. Oh yeah, I know. Coming for me. Be a lot more careful. Always with the rocks. Weird pillars with rocks. I did find you. You think I'd be able to swim across this lake? Wish I knew what you guys were for. I didn't drown. Eat a bag of dicks. I was almost ashore. Oh, there's so many fishes. Oh, made you jump out of the water. Keep running, so we don't want to attract their attention. What is that? Oh, hey. I didn't expect a crab to be under there. This crab is well known for its exceptionally sharp pinchers. When cooked, the strength compound in its claws will increase your attack power. Cool. There we go. Well, he's aggressive. Swimming around my lake? I'll get you. What is this? Is this just for me to look around? Beautiful view up here. Oh, is horseback riding. God dang it, I'm so stupid. I'm gonna get the hang of these controls sooner or later. I'm used to a certain set of buttons to going to different things for jumps and targeting and other such things. It's not that far off, but it still feels a little different. I am used to the A button or the B button in this case of this controller being the one that jumps, for instance, not running. Back here again? Oh. Alright. Eat all of your... Eat you with your own people's stuff. I'll take that. Use that as a weapon. That's a blackened crab. Crab's already been cooked for me. Yummy crab. Oh, you fucking son of... Ooh, alright, alright. Oh, there's a lot of them coming, too. Get the hell out of here. Yeah, how do you like that? Stab you, spear you through. Grab that one. And get some health. The whole purpose of making two-piece skewers was so I can fill up two hearts. Exactly. Yeah. Oh, you want to play that game? Got axes. Take your club, too. Oh, I gotta get better at that. Attracting attention to me. Mm-hmm. Maybe that was gonna happen. Thank you. Rupees. We are switching to your spiked Boko Club. That'll deal with you. Not very well, though, apparently. I need to do all of my food before I finish this combat out. Somehow my shield is broke, so I'll equip this one. There we go. Oh shit, this guy's strong. Gone through most of my weaponry doing that. God dang. What? Oh, I already did, didn't I? I did, good. Void with all bio. Void at all costs. Type situation. I need something that works as a better way to attract their attention, so I'm gonna have to sneak into this base a little bit. Just gotta figure out how to get the attention of this archer without him noticing me. Yeah, critical hit style. There we go. Down. That's a majority of the stuff in the area down a little bit more smartly. Got to focus on the people who are protecting with their alarms, apparently. So now oh yeah, okay, get all my green and red blue rupees here. So now I can take these efforts to move over. Oh, sort of. I got a guard. He's coming this way. Got anything? Yep, there we go. 2.5. Now, best way to do this, looks like it's going to be to take a shot Right at their ropes. Oh shit. Okay. There we go. That helps a lot. Ooh-wee. All right. He hits hard. Get you both. Spike club's good. Some horns and fangs. I hope that's all of the guys, man. I don't know how many more I can do with this. I'll even take the soldier broadsword. I need more room. That's what I really need. More room in this weapons inventory. We can drop you. I don't need two of you. I'm not even sure I need any of you right now. Keep this spear. At least it's full daylight now. Ooh, they had treasures. I'm glad I came over here. Keeping some amber. And some more amber. What are you guys hiding inside? Well, that's the end of that. Guts and Bokoblin fangs. Well, at least we cleared this place out. I'm sure they'll be back the next time I load in, but they had a decent supply of stuff. A minor distraction from what I intended to do, which is still working my way directly towards this extra stuff. What the hell, dude? Oh, they all are riding on horses, and I'm pretty sure he sees me. But I can't hang out by the beach because these fucking... these other things are out here. Alright, gotcha. Eh! Touch you right off your horse. There we go. I got a horse now, too. Let's get going. I know it's nearby. Oh, I see. The signal is getting bigger. Now it's beeping at me. I get what they meant. Whoa, whoa, whoa. How do I dismount? Beep. Oh, there. Hey, you. People are trying to rest here, but I've got stuff to share. So I'd better do it nice and quiet. You ready, adventurer? If you find a shop called Fang and Bone, keep an eye out for the special wares, and you can buy only at night. I will, Kazool. Anything else you got for me? Oh, that's it? Okay. Thanks, buddy. Can I steal your horse? Probably not. Alright, let's see. I see it. I see it there. You don't want to go? There you go. Oh, oh. Alright, horse. I doubt you'll be able to come with me, so. I'm just gonna swim across here and check out this shrine. This is at the very spit. Oh, hey! What do you think you're doing? You must not harm the flowers. What? The hell are you talking about? Okay. I planted flowers around the shrine. Please be careful where you step. You don't want to hurt them, do you? Oh, I guess not. Shall I come up the center then? Please take some time to really admire the flowers. I worked so hard to plant them. Okay, lady. I'll try not to walk in them. Create a maze. Flower maze. Go. Seriously, gotta walk a freaking flower maze. Oh, I want that pitchfork. There we go. Thanks for making. No. You must not hurt the flowers. They are screaming out in pain. Why'd you put one right in the middle of the path? Are you serious? Alright. I seriously have to make it through this maze of flowers. This is so silly. Alright, going around. I gotta like crawl by that last one. Cause she put it right in the center of the walkway. What's that? Holy crap. Oh, okay, well that would be useful. Yeah, I will. I just didn't realize I was going to get ambushed by a giant chew. You need to fucking chill, lady. Can't even. I cut the flowers too. So many times. I lost count of how many times I've told you. And just so many now. How do you not understand? Why don't you get it? Day after day to plant those flowers, then you come and hurt them over and over. Oh, she's just smashing up the flowers like crazy. I'm sorry, lady. I wasn't trying to. I'll make you understand. The flowers rage! Oh, shit. She just beat the shit out of me. Okay. Note to self, don't mess with the flowers or she's gonna kill you. I'll have some steak then, I guess. That'll work. Meat skewer. I just want to collect your flowers to cook them. You know? That's all. Fine, lady. How about I climb your tree? Can Can I do that without incurring your wrath? Whoop! It didn't work as well as I thought it would. The wind blew me over. Well, for me to get to that other flower, I am gonna need a spear-like weapon. Or a club, I guess. Good, that doesn't hurt him. Ours unhurt. There we go. Okay, now I should be able to get through. I don't even have a weapon in hand, so I can't accidentally do anything but maybe step on your little flowers. A big hardy radish. This hardy radish has grown much larger than the average radish. It's rich in analeptic compounds that, when cooked into a dish, temporarily increase your maximum hearts. Sweet. Now, I just gotta get back around. To the front. And crawl up real careful like. A better lady? I safely make it past your freaking flower maze? Nobody asked you to plant flowers around my shrine. People. Watch out for the flowers completed, I guess. After I took an ass whooping, the last time wasn't even my fault, I was doing it safe. Look at that little mini mission, I didn't even know I was on a little mini mission there. I could have burned all her flowers down. That would have been humorous. Alright. This is the first time I've been to a shrine off of the Great Plateau. To set foot in the shrine, I am Hila Rao. In the name of the goddess Hylia, I offer this challenge. Or trial, should I say. Well... okie doke. I can't grab it. Grab that one. Can I use the ice? Assuming that's the point. Oh no, never mind. I can actually stop it. Okay. I get it. That gets me on that one. That gets me across here. Guess that was it. Seems like this should be more complex than it is, but... magnetic? Ooh. Well, I could stop that by putting another ice block under that. By freezing it here. There we go. That's that. I got ice arrows now. That's cool. Does that do me any good? I'm gonna jump off this thing before. Oop, shit. Alright. So freaking, no, thank goodness. I'm so freaking gonna drown. Well, apparently it goes right around the thing, so. Okay, if I put one like right here so I can see what I'm doing. I can climb up here. And these things can hopefully go around me. Well, whatever. I need to blow them up. I mean, I could just target them, blow them up from there, but this way, I can catch one. Okay. And that doesn't work. All right. I gotta get a better position. Oh, let me see. There we go. That'll work. Now that should put it out of the water and therefore make it able to blow up the wall. I feel like there was a treasure. Oh, I know. I got the treasure already. Huh, I'm dumb. Alright, well, what do I get out of this? Flowers? The ability to grow things? Your resourcefulness in overcoming this trial speaks to the promise of a hero. In the name of the goddess Hylia, I bestow upon you this spirit orb. I got that. Was that it? Just solve the puzzle? May Goddess smile upon you. I suppose you wouldn't learn a new ability every single time. That would be crazy. I gotta go back. Alright. Stop messing up any of your flowers. Crazy lady with her flower set up. Better? Look, do you see? The shrine has changed a pretty color. You must be pleased with my gorgeous flowers. Yeah, that's it. It's your flowers, lady. Alright. Well, I don't have any other directions to go on all of this stuff. I want to get back to where I was quickly. Because I still need to go up through Dueling Peaks. Or I can go straight across, I suppose. That's a shrine. That on the other side of Dueling Peak? Oh yeah, it is. How would I get up there? Jeez. I'm gonna go port here. See ya, lady. Crazy lady. Forest spirits called Koroks like to hide in unexpected spots. I know it's near me. I was like, why is it doing that? I'm gonna do my very best to climb straight up to it. Cancel. I do have the skills to do it, though. I just gotta figure out how to bypass up here. Walking back and forth, I guess. Oh shit, I don't have a weapon out. There we go. What are these? Do I need like a mining hammer for this? Huh. Yeah, I know. Be able to keep going straight up. Ooh-wee. Alright. The last segment's gonna be a little tougher. Might be best if I just go up by foot. if it lets me. Yeah, I know it's nearby. Left his head rolling down the hill. I do have stuff to develop stamina, so I might have to use that to get a little a better distance up here. That one doesn't add much. None of them really do. Oh, I expected one of them to do it. Okay. Boy. I won't have wasted 3 meals trying to get to the peak of this thing. This be enough, because I don't have any more to go. This is a resting spot. Oh, thank goodness. Okay. I know it's here. No, I'm looking in the right direction right now. I might be able to make it to the top if I slow climb this one. There you go, pick up some speed. At least I didn't fall down hard. Alright, let's see if I can find a better way. Looks like I can run around the edges of this. Chew jelly. Yeah, easier to run around. Oh, we climb higher and higher. Yeah, I know it's over here. There's probably another one in that general direction somewhere too. When I get to the top, I'll be able to tell. It'd be funny if this starts to go back down on its own. And I had wasted my time climbing up because this was the actual direction I should have been going all along. God, I wish I had a hammer for all that. There it is. Is that a different one? Please don't tell me I'm climbing the wrong side. I'm gonna go ahead and target that though. I'm hoping there's two. And that's why it keeps double beeping at me. Lord, oh Lord, all right. I'm gonna have to find a way to do this. Getting to that one will be easy. Let's jump across here. See what those rocks are about, and then climb around. But I thought there was one up top. And it looks like, yeah, there is. Okay, I'm not crazy. So what are these about? Ooh, I know what I can do. I can Or I could just push them off, I suppose. Instead of wasting all that energy. Get out of here, you big old rocks. Nobody wants you. I knew it had to be something. Yeah, I guess so. Doesn't seem like where I was at, but whatever. Oh, I hit the tree. Is that what that point was? To try to field goal that? I had no idea. Alright. Yeah, that one's gonna be tough. That would have been a sheer upside down face. This one I can do though. That one I could probably do. Our cliff edges. Good lord, are they far apart. Man. Shee, Venath Shrine. Sets foot in the shrine, I am Shee Venath. In the name of the goddess Hylia, I offer this trial. Twin memory. Shrines atop these peaks share a connection. the memory the answer to the other question. Oh, commit to memory before you start, lest a failure you will depart. What now? Okay. Alright, I am not gonna tackle this right now because I actually happen to have a responsibility to take care of. So I will try to stream again later on this afternoon. More than likely I'll record videos for Alien Isolation, but anyway, I will, I will definitely be returning to this quite often. If you enjoyed this series, please give it a thumbs up. Otherwise, give it a thumbs down so I'll know not to waste my time on it. Otherwise, I'll see you guys in the next feed. Have a great day.